Hello YouTube, this is Prometheus 1979-9791. Today I'm getting to the long overdue review of the Spyderco Sage. You've seen me compare it to other knives in other videos. You've seen me use it in the cut, the 10 steel edge retention test videos, as it was one of the victors. But this knife, I've had it for, I don't know, probably a month or two. And it's always been my secondary carry, or along with the Spyderco Tenacious. Up until I got those knives, this was my primary carry after I got done with the BL06-1 review for the 1 month. And I have never had a single bit of blade play develop in this, not even a smidgen. The lock kind of looks like it's about at about 50% or so. It has not moved over even a smidge since I've owned this. There's no lock rock. Opens up real nice and smooth. The handles seem to be pretty resilient. They aren't all scratched up and nasty looking or anything. And pocket clip. I'd say this attachment method for the pocket clip is probably one of the best I've seen on knives, unless a company can take and on a regular pocket clip like the and machine out a little pad underneath of it so that it fits right in and screws down so that you don't develop the little bit of movement. But it's a really good steel. I really love this steel. This and the CPM 3V on the Spyderco Tough have to be my two top favorites at the moment. I can sharpen this thing just razor sharp with the most minimal of effort. In fact, this probably, in my opinion, has to be one of the easiest steels to sharpen. And I really just haven't done very much to sharpen it at all. I can have this thing sharp in 2 or 3 minutes using mainly what I use is a 2000 grit stone from a Lansky sharpening system. It's a sapphire polishing stone. Without using the system, I just use the stone by itself. And occasionally I use my combination Norton stone. It was the one that was featured in the Sanrenmu 120 day EDC review. And I really, if and when I have to use this on a more aggressive stone like that, it's really not that aggressive. I just use it on the fine side. I really don't have to do much work to sharpen it at all. It just glides, you know, you get done with that and you finish it off with a 2000 grit and it just glides right through paper. This razor sharp. Hair popping sharp. This is probably the most impressive steel I've worked with, aside from maybe the CPM 3V so far. I've been working with that for 3 weeks now, going on 4. Be doing a review, 4 week review on the Spyderco Tough here on Friday. But so far, I really like the ergonomics. Even with this choil, they are really pretty comfortable. This is a great grip for making like horizontal slices and things. Actually, it works pretty good for vertical slices too. Sometimes, I mean, because I like to, when I make a vertical cut, I like to kind of face the tip down a bit so that it forces all the material being cut up under the edge, farther up under the blade. And works really great for that. I personally feel that this is the most comfortable on the left hand. This bit of a notch out here for the accessing the lock here, it kind of butts up against the base of my finger. You can see right there. Wrap your fingers around it. Still got a good full forefinger grip. You can see that full forefinger grip with the left, you know, in my left hand, and my middle finger kind of comes down on this divot in the pocket clip, and it just as the most comfortable position to carry it. And if you even move forward like this, put your ring finger in that divot on the pocket clip, and just really is a very comfortable position for it. It's pretty good in the right hand, but as your finger kind of folds over the lock, you can kind of feel the edge of the lock. So not quite as comfortable, but there's really nothing to complain about. It's not really a hot spot or anything. It's just you can just definitely tell that it's there. I'm left-handed, but that doesn't mean my right arm hangs lifeless at my side. In fact, I probably use my right arm just as much as my left. I suppose you could say I was ambidextrous, but anyway, this knife seems good for both. And as you can see, I can open it and close it with my left hand pretty well. There's no trouble there. It's pretty stinking awesome. I noticed that I kind of need to lube it up a little bit though. It's not quite as smooth when you go to flick it open. Probably just from carry. Probably got some lint or dust or something in the pivot. In my opinion, this also is probably one of the best EDC type knives. It's just the right length. You know, get your full grip on it. The blade's not too long, so it gives you good leverage as you're closer to the tip of the blade for control. You know, it just seems to give you a lot better control for making slices and stuff. And I have gotten quite a bit of use out of this. I just think that as far as knives go, that this is one that definitely has a place in everybody's collection if you're using knives for everyday chores. You know, using it for cardboard. I use it to cut like rubber tubing or hose, and there's just a multitude of different things I use it for. Cutting tape, plastic, cutting wood, you know, whittling, just all kinds of things. And I definitely have to say that this meets my expectations, and actually it exceeds them. So I think that for the money, that it's probably one of the best EDC knives you can get. So anyways, thanks for watching. Hope this was a little bit helpful. I'll probably do another update on it sometime or another. And just want to say thanks again for watching this Prometheus 1979 9791.